When we talk about the structure of agribusiness markets, the common teachings is that we talk about a perfectly competitive market. Under this perfectly competitive market, we say that we have so many buyers and so many sellers that not one buyer or one seller can influence the market in any way, that everybody becomes a price taker. We also say that the products are homogeneous products, meaning that all of the products are the same, that you cannot tell corn from one farm as being different from corn from another farm. We say that it is a commodity and therefore it's the same good. We also say that there are no barriers to entry or exit. And whenever we talk about the agricultural sector, if we look at it from a very broad spectrum, we can say that all of these classifications fit. We can say that as a whole, there are so many buyers and sellers that no one buyer or seller can influence the market on a grand scale. We also say that as a result, yeah, corn is corn, beef is beef, that these commodities are homogeneous products that you really can't tell a difference in. And then also, as a result, as a whole, there really aren't many barriers to entry or exit on a grand scale in agriculture. So whenever we talk about that, we usually talk about it being perfectly competitive markets. But in reality, this simply just isn't always the case. One of the first things that I'll make a point is that oftentimes firms are large enough to dictate the market in specific markets. So think about it this way. You go to an individual cattle auction and there's one buyer there that buys up half of the cattle there. He did just have an influence on the price. He probably bid up the prices just a little bit. So that one buyer buying half of the cattle, that one buyer is large enough to influence that particular market, making that market no longer under that perfect competition. Another aspect is we do have a product and service differentiation. We do offer extra services and different types of products that cause our agricultural goods to not always be these homogeneous products that we've talked about under perfect competition. And then another thing is there are sometimes barriers. Market size may be a barrier to entry. So an example of that would be, let's say that there is one, say, grain elevator in an area, and a second one is looking to open up in that area. Typically, there's not anything to keep them from opening up that second grain elevator. But there actually is something that's a barrier, and that is the market. There may not be a large enough market to open up two grain elevators in this one particular area. So that would be a barrier to entry. So whenever we typically talk about the structure of agribusiness markets, we talk about them being this perfectly competitive market. But in reality, that's just not the case because of the various reasons that we just discussed in this video.